Hi, welcome to the second session on Digital Principles and System Design. In this video, we'll start with the number system. A number system consists of a finite set of symbols. We usually colloquially call those symbols as digits. And the number of symbols in a number system decides the radix or the base of the number system. Say for example, if you take the decimal number system, the radix or the base of the decimal number system is 10. Why? Because it has 10 symbols, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 9. Totally we have 10 different symbols in this number system. And why do we wanted to learn the decimal number system? Because that is the number system that we are familiar with. So we'll start with what is familiar to us and go to the next number system, which is the binary number system, which is the language of the machine, the computer. So it has only two symbols, 0 and 1. So the base of the binary number system or the radix of the binary number system is 2. And we learn the binary number system because we wanted to understand the language of the computer. And the next number system is the octal number system, which has 8 different symbols. The radix of octal number system is 8. Remember, the octopus has 8 hands. Octo means 8. Okay, so it is octal number system. So we have 8 different symbols from 0 to 7. The next is the hexadecimal number system, which has 16 different symbols, which include 0 to 9, 10 numbers as symbols, and 6 alphabets from English from A to F as symbols of hexadecimal number system. And why we wanted to learn octal number system or hexadecimal number system? The reason is very simple. Because the base of octal number system or the hexadecimal number system is some power of the base of the binary number system. That is, I can write 8 as 2 to the power 3, which is some power of 2, which is 3. And here I can write 16 as 2 to the power 4. Okay, so instead of writing 3 bits in binary, I will have only one digit in octal. So I can reduce the size of the binary string, which is nothing but sequence of ones and zeros, to 1/3 size if I use octal number system. And if I use hexadecimal number system, each hexadecimal number system can represent 4 bit pattern in binary. So 4 bits together I can write as a single hexadecimal number. So it improves readability for human being, no other special reason. Now let's consider the number representation. So any number you can write it as integer part, and optionally you can have a fractional part. Say for example, in this case 123.45, this point is the radix point. If this number belong to decimal number system, we call this point as decimal point. Suppose this number system is octal number system, we call this point as octal point. So the integer part is something that appears before the radix point, and fractional part is the digits that appear after the radix point. Now when we write, suppose if you assume that this number is in decimal number system, this is positional representation of the number. Okay, this is 123.45. that means that I have 1 hundredths, 2 tens, 3 units and 0.45. okay, each digit has a positional weight. If we ignore the positional weight and represent the number, we call that as a positional notation. Otherwise, if we explicitly write with the positional weightage, okay, it is 1 hundredths, so it is 10 square, and 2 tens, 10 to the power 1, 3 units, 10 to the power 0, anything raised to the power 0 is 1, and 4 is actually 1 by 10th of 4, and 5 is 1 by 100th of 5, and so on. And this way of representing the number is called the polynomial notation. Now let's consider the number conversion. We have four different number systems: decimal, binary, octal, and hexadecimal. And I should be able to convert a number from one number system to any other number system. So we will have in this video, in particular, we will consider the conversion of decimal number system to any other number system. So here, when I wanted to convert a decimal number to any other number system with radix r, I have to treat the integer part separately and fractional part separately. Assume that now the number has only the integer part, that is, the optional fractional part is not given. In this case, we can divide the integer part by the radix r and write the quotient down and remainder by the side of the quotient. We can repeat this operation, step number 1, 2, 3, till the quotient becomes a number which is less than r. And now we can get the number, the integer part of the number, in the required number system with radix r by writing the last quotient followed by the remainders written from bottom to top. We'll see an example to understand this procedure. Let's consider the number 1234 in decimal number system, and I wanted to convert this number to binary number system. So the radix of binary number system is 2. So I'm going to divide 1234 by 2 repeatedly. So when I divide, I'll get 617, and the remainder is 0 because 1, 2, 3, 4 is an even number. And when I divide this 617 by 2 again, we'll get the quotient 308. The remainder is 1. And we'll divide this 308 and we'll get 1 by 2, and we'll get 154, remainder 0. And we keep on repeatedly dividing the quotient till we get a remainder which is less than this r. Now, the result of this one, that is, when I want to convert 1234 in decimal number system to binary number system, I have to write the quotient, the last quotient, and then the remainders from bottom to top. So I'll have 100110 100010 in binary number system. Suppose if I wanted to convert the same number to octal number system, I have to repeatedly divide this number by 8. So when we divide this by 8, okay, we get 1 1 2 3 2. The remainder is going to be 2. And when we divide 154 by 19, we get 1 5 2, and the remainder is 2. And again, when we divide this 19 by 8, we get 2 as the quotient, and the remainder is 3. And this 2 is less than r, which is 8. So the answer will be the 1234 in decimal number system is equal unto 2322 in octal number system. Similarly, if we consider an example from hexadecimal number, I wanted to convert 1234 in decimal number system to octal number system. So we will, since the radix of hexadecimal number system is 16, I will divide 1234 by 16 and we get 77. The remainder is 2. Again we will divide this by 16, we get 64. 4 16s are 64. So the quotient is 4, the remainder is 13. Remember, when we have hexadecimal number system, we have numbers from 0 to 9, which will represent the numbers actually from 0 to 9, and then 10 in decimal number system will be represented by A, the English alphabet, and 11 in decimal number system is represented by B, 12 in decimal number system is represented by C in hexadecimal, and D will represent 13 in decimal number system. So when you get a remainder here, which is 13, we will not write this as 13, but instead we will write it in hexadecimal, which is D. So the number 1234 in decimal is equivalent to 4D2 in hexadecimal.